going into your fourth season here as the head coach of the Mounties. I know how much you love it and you're passionate about this team. Tell me, what's the team looking like going into the regular season opener on Friday night?
Yeah, we're excited. It's like Christmas coming here this week almost for us. Buzz back here. The weather's actually, yeah, like you said, it's a little dreary tonight here. But it's exciting and at the rink. We got a busy week for our team prepping for Friday and Saturday's games. But we got a lot of energy with the boys. We got a lot of kids back. And a lot of guys will be to rock and roll here shortly.
What do you think the identity of this team is going to be? Every team is different from year to year to year, right? You've been around hockey a long time. You've coached hockey for a long time. When you look at this group specifically, what do you think is going to define the 2018-2019 Paris Mounties?
Well, if I was to look at it right now and the perfect answer, I'd say defense first, and we're going to play one-nothing hockey games.
But spoken like a true coach.
I think we're looking at a few more options this year. We're going to have a lot of speed. We got a lot of returning forwards up front, which should be exciting to watch in the sense that we're going to score a lot of goals is the plan. And then goaltending, I think we're pretty solid. And then our back end right now, we're a little bit younger. We got some experience that we're going to build on back there this year and help some of the younger guys. But, yeah, lots of speed. Lots of goals, and definitely gonna have some good goaltending too, I think. So we've got pretty good balance right now.
Yeah, it sounds like a perfect mix of things. And obviously everybody's pretty optimistic in the preseason, but I can't argue with you. You've got Justin Hergott back there as your number one goaltender. He was outstanding for you in the playoffs last year. He was a brilliant 1-2 combination, obviously, with Davis McLean. But Davis graduating puts Justin into the number one role. How much are you going to lean on him? Because at the end of the day, he's going to be the backbone of this team. You hope to win 1-0 because you're a hockey coach, but realistically that's not going to happen, right?
Yeah, exactly. It's you know, Hergott's a great guy, a great individual. He's quiet in the room, but his ability to stop pucks is it's phenomenal. If you watch him on a regular basis, I'm lucky to do so. He's going to be a rock back there for us. Obviously, he's going to, you know, turn away everything that we're expecting of, and you know, have the defense work around them and push the puck up to our forwards. We also got a nice young kid that came in this year as a surprise, Jack Fowler, and he's going to be able to push Hergy too for some spots. And like I said, I don't think goaltending is going to be an issue with us this year, hopefully.
Tell us a little bit about Jack. Introduce him to us as a player, as a goaltender.
Yeah, he surprisingly, I actually coached him, I think, 3 or 4 years ago in some prospect things, and he kind of fell off the map in the sense that I usually follow the kids that I coach pretty closely, and he was playing in Hamilton minor midget at the time, and I think he ended up then the last couple of years, I believe, he's been in Chicago at Lake Forest Prep School, and had 2 years, I think, down there that he's been there now, and wanted to come home this year, finished his last year high school. We got some friends that, you know, we signed a couple of guys that he's played with in the past and stuff. So it was nice to see him show up to camp, and he jumped and fitted right in with everybody here. So it's been a good fit that way for sure.
Yeah, it sounds great. You're bringing a goaltender like that from down south. And you know what? Real promising from the sounds of it. Talk to me about the back end. Obviously, Jacob Norcott is a big loss back there. So like you said, you're a little bit less experienced. But you know what? I bet you got some horses back there who are going to log some big minutes and make a difference for you. Who are some of those players this year, Brad, that we can expect to step up?
Definitely Ethan Hebel. He's back with us. Going to be a leader on the back end. Again, he's a quiet guy, but he's physical. He jumps up, has a little bit of an offensive flair. A lot of guys are looking up into him in the room. We did have Will Hurley, a Brantford boy, played Junior B the last 2 years, I believe. He's come in. He's going to school now in Simcoe, and has kind of dropped back from the Junior B ranks. And he's going to be a guy that's a smooth skater, moves the puck well. It's almost effortlessly watching it. It's unbelievable how quick he can just get up and down the ice. So he'll be a nice fit back there. And then, honestly, we got probably 5 kids right now that we have signed that, I don't know, I can't really see front runner is going to be. They all have good attitudes. They all bring different dimensions. We've got some speed. We got some size. We got guys that are offensive. We got guys that like to stay home and, you know, stand people up on the blue line. So it's going to be a good opportunity to see how things shake out here. I have enjoyed watching camp and the compete level for anything from just a scrimmage game or a battle drill or even our exhibition games on the weekend. There's a lot of ups and there's a lot of guys into the program right now this time of year.
It sounds like you've got some good problems.
Yeah, I could have a few headaches here early on, but like I said, it's everything's up for grabs, and it's going to be earned this year. So it's nice to have that competition, and they all are aware of it. So we'll see how it shakes out here.
I'll tell you, one of my favorite players to watch on your team, and it's just because he's lightning fast, and he can make something out of nothing, and he can make things happen, and he's such a great kid, Ben Cripps. He's back for another season. Obviously, this kid is a fan favorite, and he can make great plays. And I know you want to win 1-0, but boy, Ben Cripps can put the puck in the net, and he can do it in dazzling ways. How excited are you to have him back? And I assume he'll be one of your leaders, probably offensively.
Yeah, he's he's on the shelf right now. He's going to be probably missing the first week to a couple. I don't even know officially yet, but he had an ankle injury there in the summer there. So he's coming off of that. He's in good physical shape, like always. Mm-hmm. Probably one of the fastest, if not the fastest guy in the league. And when the puck gets on his stick, he can make or break a game quite easily on how much he puts into the game and what he wants to do with it. So he's a lot of fun to watch. He's really grown the last couple of years with me. He came in from a midget program in Brantford, and I know talking to him, he's excited. He's around the rink. He's in the guy's ears, and I know he's chomping up a bit to get back on the ice. So it'll be exciting when we get that thrown into the lineup here in a few weeks. It'll be fun to see.
Did you just give me an injury update on a player and didn't say lower body?
Yeah, I'm pretty.
Right? Like, you're not in playoff mode yet, that's for sure.
No. Talk to me in January is a different story. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, Benjamin Cripps is not in the lineup. We don't know why, and he might have an injury. Something like that?
I wouldn't even say an injury. I'd just say I don't know where he is. Yeah. So he's pretty quiet on that front.
Alex Ritchie, your captain, you named him a couple of weeks ago. Again, a great kid, a quiet leader, I would say, but one of those kids that leads by example. Why was Alex the best fit to lead this group? Blake Cully, he learned a lot from last year. Blake was the captain for your hockey club leading into the second round. Similar style, in my opinion, but do you agree with that, and how do you see Alex leading this team?
Yeah, like they played together last year on the same line. I think they actually sat beside each other in the dressing room. They were always in each other's ear, and not the most vocal guys in the sense of yell and scream and get their message across that way, but definitely guys that when they spoke, everybody else in the room kind of turned their head or their ear and made sure they dialed in on what was being said. And Alex brings a lot. He's passionate about this team. He's a hometown kid, which is pretty cool, I think, just to have a captain of a hometown team. It's something special. You don't get to see that too often these days. So to step up in that thing, he's got an offensive flair. Plays the game, thinks the game very well. Mm-hmm. He's probably going to be a really good coach at least this level or higher in the future, because he's pretty smart when it comes to the X's and O's and seeing things that way. So it's good to have that with their dressing room, and I know a lot of guys are going to lean on them early on, especially to lead the team here through the first couple of coming weeks.
Let's get to know Brad Jones a little bit. You're going into your fourth season as the Paris Mounties head coach. What is it about this league, this level, this age group that motivates you? What do you like most about your job, Brad?
Coming to the rink, I don't look at it as a job, to be honest. I was really fortunate enough to play the game for a long time and do a lot of things, and I had a kind of an injury that kind of ended it for playing competitively. Mm-hmm. And I was really fortunate to be brought into the program, and I really wasn't sure if I was going to be, ready for the junior level and stuff like that, but I got an opportunity, and it just became just really passionate about it. It was exciting coming to the rink, and, you're dealing with young men that are good hockey players, but you're dealing with good people, and that's been the big thing that I think I've tried to do here over the last couple of years, especially, is bringing good people. And it's nice to see kids develop and go on past just the junior level and do things with their life. There's kids now that I had my first year that are going to chiropractic school and engineering and all this other stuff. So it's a pretty cool feeling to be a part of that. I still got my competitive nature. I love winning. Who doesn't like to win? So, and that's my one thing right now that's kind of biting me a little bit, is that, I haven't won yet in this league, and that's something that, is really high on my list, obviously, and I know the boys want to do the same this year. So, we push towards that this year.
And the fan base has grown in Paris over the last number of years since Todd Wood took over. He's the general manager of the hockey club. I know you and Todd have a great relationship between head coach and general manager. He listens to you and you listen to him. How much do you think that helps with just making the Mounties a more attractive organization for a recruit, that you've got a head coach and a general manager who are on the same page and want to do good things and produce good people, not only good hockey players?
I have to be careful what I say here, because it's all the power, so I don't want to get myself into any trouble here.
Don't get fired in the preseason, Brad.
No, on a serious note, though, Todd, it's a unique situation. Ever since kind of day one that I took over here, we've been on the same page. Yeah, we have a few disagreements and maybe not see eye to eye on some things, but, like, that's very rare. Todd's given me a lot of opportunity. I have grown a lot of relationships in the junior C and P loops over the years now, and you see how organizations kind of run things, and I do have a lot of flexibility when it comes to, you know, who I like and don't like, and we get together and we have a good scouting staff and everything like that, and It just seems to work well. And when you have something like that and the program that we have here, Todd puts an excellent effort. It's 24 hours 365 days a year for him. He's getting sponsors. He's trying to do everything he can for the players. Like, there's these kids on our team, they get treated very well. And I'm going to say, I haven't seen too many programs that get the same things that we do here. And we're very fortunate for it. And when it's a really good spot, I do everything in my power to keep where I am and keep working for it, because I don't really want to go anywhere else, to be honest. I like where I am. And like I said, my main goal is to get a championship back to Paris.
We're talking with Brad Jones, the head coach of the Paris Mounties, on the 519 Sports Online radio show here on FM 98.5 CKWR. I want to quickly touch on the balance that you've got, Brad. You have a full-time job, obviously. You have a family, and you've got hockey a couple of nights a week. You know, we talk about the players all the time, right? Between their studies and between hockey and between travel and between practices. You say you love it, and I totally know that. However, it's got to be a lot for you sometimes, too. How do you sort of manage your time to try to stay on top of everything?
Well, and I should say this so I don't get in trouble again, too. I got a really good wife. We were really fortunate. We had a baby girl here in July. I switched job in June. And, you know, it's a lot in the sense that you need to have a really good supporting cast around you. And my wife, she's a rock and supports everything I do.
Yeah.
I was a little fearful when we were going to have the baby here that maybe hockey had to kind of shut down for a year or two just to take time with the family. But she's been very nice and fortunate to say, hey, it's your passion. It's what you like to do. And she, you know, stands beside me for that. So I'm really lucky for that opportunity. And like I said, for work, it's you got to kind of be upfront with them. And they understand kind of how passionate I am about hockey and what it means to me. And like I said, I got to do everything I can, but it's a big thing this week. Stuff at the rink every day other than tonight, and things that you should be doing when you're playing so you don't run yourself dry. But when you love something this much, it's in my blood, and it's what I like to do. So just got to find ways to get her done.
For more highlights, visit our website, 519sportsonline.ca. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.